Hello and welcome back to GeForce's coverage of CES. I'm Julian and I'm here with Mark Aevermann. We're going to talk about RTX laptops. Mark, that was the other big announcement from Jensen at his keynote speech along with the RTX 2060. And there's a ton of laptops coming out, right?
There are, yeah. We have over 40 designs that are coming out from every manufacturer across the world, system builders as well. There's a ton of choice for gamers. The 2080 is coming to laptops, 2070 and 2060. Not only are there 40 designs, 17 of those designs are Max-Q. So there's a lot of thin, light, powerful laptops that are also going to be available.
Yeah, and you guys aren't just talking. You're actually showing those off here. Behind us is a selection of those Max-Q laptops. What is it that separates a Max-Q laptop from a non-Max-Q laptop?
Yeah, good question. So Max-Q is a design approach, and it's about balancing every last aspect of the laptop for maximum portability. It's balancing weight constraints, thermal constraints, electrical constraints, cost constraints. And what that means is you can fit in much more performance than you could in a machine as thin as 16 millimeters. We have a new laptop from Asus that is the world's thinnest gaming laptop we've ever seen. 16 millimeters, it's incredible.
Some of them are just award-winning classics that have been brought into the new, like this MSI over here, right? Like this looks kind of familiar.
Yeah, it should. It won a lot of awards last year. MSI GS65 is getting updated. It's better than ever before. It's now sporting up to the RTX 2080. It's got thin bezels, 144 hertz panel. It's Optimus, so the battery life is great. It is a fantastic machine. I can't wait to see it get reviewed and picked up by gamers.
Yeah, it's a pretty piece of work, but you know, those specs, you see them over and over a lot of these Max-Q laptops,
right? That's right, yeah. Just the quality across the board has really come up with this generation. This is definitely the best crop of gaming laptops we've ever seen. A lot of them have 144 hertz panels. A lot of them are thin bezel. A lot of them are Optimus. And now with RTX series, they're capable of much faster speeds than ever before. They're capable of ray tracing. They, of course, have the Tensor Core. So now you can do DLSS on a gaming laptop. So these are powerful technical machines.
I have a Razer Blade from 2016. It's got a 1060 in it. I love it to pieces. But behind me, there's a Blade with a 2080 crammed in there. How do you guys pull that off?
We work very closely with Razer about designing that, again, following that Max-Q design approach. So they've developed a system that's better than ever before. Again, cooler, quieter, much more powerful. And of course, with all the RTX technology that we've built into Turing.
Yeah, 6 months ago, ray tracing real-time in video games was unheard of. And now it's coming to a portable form factor. Like, what's it like to see that actually realized?
It's pretty crazy. Yeah, Battlefield 5, for instance, ray tracing on Ultra, graphics on Ultra, smooth gameplay. It's insane, right? Yeah. With an RTX 2080.
Well, thank you so much for telling us about these Max-Q laptops today.
My pleasure.
Thank you guys for tuning in here on GeForce. Don't forget, we have our contest going on where we are giving away RTX 2080 Ti graphics cards to those who subscribe and leave comments on our coverage of CES. Don't miss out on that, and I'll see you next time on GeForce.